Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. In today's video, the last game from the London Chess Classic 2019. We are going to watch the first rapid game between Ding and Vachier Lagrave, with Ding that already won one of the two classical games. Let's get started. Ding with the white pieces opens with d4, Vachier Lagrave answers with knight to f6, here comes c4, g6, it seems a king's Indian, but it will become something different. g3, c5 now attacking the center. Knight to f3 first. Now in this position, c captures on d4 is not a bad idea. Instead, here comes bishop to g7, that of course is also perfectly fine. Bishop to g2, short castle for black, and d5. Now with this pawn structure, the game becomes a modern Benoni. Here comes d6, knight to c3, e6 attacking the central pawn, short castle for white, and e captures on d5. C captures on d5. Rook to e8, that controlling e4 is preventing this e4 push, but Ding answers with rook to f1 that will help the pawn to advance. Now in this position, here comes bishop to f5, and even if this is a natural move, it's not one of the main continuation. Let's go back one move, let's watch the main line. a6 is the main line to expand on the queenside. So here comes a4 preventing b5, knight in b goes to d7, and finally white is able to play e4. But now with knight to g4 that will prevent the e4 push, here comes knight back to d2, knight to g5, knight in g moves to e5, and now of course it's not possible to push with f4 because knight to d3 will win the bishop. So in this position, bishop back to f1 controlling this knight jump to d3, and in this position black has three good moves: knight back to g8, knight to f6, and even g5, that is a very good move because after f4 the knight will retreat to g6, that is a very active square for this knight. The position is completely equal. Let's go back to our game. We said bishop to f5, not the best move, not the best move order, let's say. Here comes knight back to d2, that will help support e4. Knight to a6 in this position is a novelty, because even if this maneuver, knight to a6, knight back to c7, is common in the Benoni, but not with this move order. So the game is now original, but white has a good advantage. In fact, now e4 comes with tempo. Bishop to g4 first is good. f3. Bishop back to d7 is another inaccuracy. Bit better, bishop back to c8. Knight to c4 comes with tempo, attacking d6. Queen to b8, protecting the pawn. And now bishop to f4, increasing the pressure against d6. So black is forced to bring back the bishop to f8. And here comes a4, that is a very good move, preventing any counterplay here on the queen side. And this is something really bad for black. The knight jumps to b4, queen to d2, knight to h5 targeting the bishop. This bishop is important, cannot be changed, so bishop to g5. And now in this position, here comes f6, and this is a good move, and it's the only possible good pawn advance. Let's go back one move. In fact, this position b5 now doesn't work, doesn't solve any problem. Let's watch what happens. With b5, there is a captures on b5, bishop captures, knight captures, queen captures, bishop back to f1, indirectly attacking the queen, queen back to d7, now g4, knight back to g7, white has the bishop pair and total control. So not a good position to play for black. So let's go back to our game. We said f6 targeting the bishop is good, bishop back to e3, and now f5. This is not a bad idea. Could this f5 could be prepared better with knight back to g7? Probably. Let's watch what happens. If knight back to g7 now with the idea of f5, now there is g4 that is preventing this pawn push, but black can change plan with b6, bishop to f4, and a6 with the idea of course b5 now. Of course, also in this position there is an advantage for white, but this is another idea to keep in mind. Let's go back to our game. We said f5, e captures on f5, bishop captures on f5, and now g4 attacking both the bishop and the knight seems a winning fork, but is not, because bishop to d3 is attacking the unprotected knight on c4. So bishop b2 f1, bishop captures on f1, and the king recaptures on f1. The knight that is under attack must move back. Knight to f6, and here bishop to g5 attacking the unprotected knight. This is an important moment of the game because black must really be careful. There is only one move that keeps Vachier Lagrave in the game. Let's start with the blunders. King to g7 is a blunder not played by Vachier Lagrave, because here comes bishop captures on f6 with check, king captures on f6, rook captures on e8, queen captures, and knight to e4 attacking both the king and d6. Now, if the king moves back to, of course, f7, there is the knight fork winning the queen. So, king to g7 is the best move. Now, queen to c3 we check. If king to g8, there is another pawn fork. If the king moves to f7, there is another pawn fork on d6, because even if the bishop captures the first knight, there is the reload winning the queen. So king to h6 is the only way to save the queen, but then checkmate is coming. At first, g5. King to h5, now f4 is very good because it opens this rank for the queen, and queen captures on e4 is not possible because there is queen to h3 that is already checkmate. Let's go back to our bishop to g5. So we said king to g7 is a blunder. Also, knight to d7 is losing, because here comes rook to e6, rook captures, d captures with tempo against the knight, knight to b6, knight captures, a captures, e7 protected by the bishop, bishop to g7, now rook to e1, the queen must move to e8 to stop the pawn, but here comes queen captures on d6, queen to d8 is in the cards with a winning simplification, because of course black will be a piece up. Let's go back to our game. After bishop to g5, Vachier Lagrave plays the best move, bishop to g7. Now bishop b2 f4, and what to do now? Vachier Lagrave continues with queen to d8, and we can ask ourselves, why not again bishop back protecting this pawn? Because this pawn is going to fall anyway. Let's watch, let's go back. If bishop back to f8, now there is rook to f6 attacking this unprotected knight, rook captures, d captures, queen to c7, but this pawn recaptures, opens also the d file, and there are three pieces attacking d6 that will also fall, of course. So after bishop to f4, queen to d8, knight captures on d6 attacking the rook, rook to f8, and now king to g2. Queen to d7 is clever because there is in the cards this possible sacrifice. So here comes bishop back to g3, preventing any tactics here on g4. Now h5 and g5 attacking the knight. Knight back to e8 with the idea of exchanging as many pieces as possible. Rook to e6, the idea is to capture here on g6. h4 first, bishop to f4, h3 we check, and now king to g3, and not king captures on h3, that is terrible because the knight can capture here, and of course there is the bishop that can recapture, but it's a problem because the rook is pinned. So king to g3, the best move, knight captures on d6, and now another moment where white must pay attention. Here comes bishop captures on d6, and this is the only good recapture, because let's remember, guys, the Benoni is a snake. Let's go back one move. If now rook captures on d6 with tempo against the queen, here comes queen to f5, two pieces attacking f4, knight to e4, knight to c2, of course with tempo against the rook, but this is a deflection. The queen cannot capture, or here there is the queen that capture, we check, and it's a mess, because we also recapture here on f3. So rook to f1 protecting f3, Knight back to d4, and incredible but true, black is now winning. Let's make a free move. If now a5, for example, is played, queen captures, we check. The queen recaptures, but now knight to e2, we check, wins a piece. So let's go back to our game. Vachier Lagrave captures with knight. The only good recapture is with the bishop, and of course Ding recaptures with the bishop with tempo against the rook. Now rook to f5, and the second rook comes to e1. Bishop back to f8, with the same idea of trying to exchange as many pieces as possible, doesn't work, because here comes rook captures on g6, we check. King to h7, the second rook moves to the 6th rank, and this is a real mess. Rook to e8, bishop captures on f8, rook captures, the rook recaptures, rook captures on f8, but now after f4, black resigns, because not only Ding is 2 pawns up, but he also has some great attacking chances with queen to e2 and later queen to h5, we check. In this position is plus 9. In my opinion, quite a beautiful game in De Benoni, not something that we often watch at this top level of chess. Vachier Lagrave didn't play the best opening move order, and Ding was able to build a very strong attack. Ding is the winner of the Grand Chess Tour, Vachier Lagrave, of course, in second place, Magnus Carlsen in third place, and Aronian in fourth place. Our analysis is over, also this tournament is over, but don't forget to subscribe to the channel, because in just 2 days, the fourth and final leg of the FIDE Grand Prix will begin in Jerusalem, in Israel. Our analysis is over, thank you very much for watching, and see you soon. Goodbye!